Welcome back. This is the second and also the last episode for reverse engineering the Seitz caravan end caps for blinds. This time it is about the lower end caps. We will do the things a bit differently this time. First, let's see the end result, the comparison between the original parts and the 3D printed parts. Here are some pictures with the original parts that are a bit yellow and the copied parts that are white. Let me know in the comments below if you think those turned out okay. Let's check a 3D printing time lapse. The printer is a Prusa i3 Mark III printing with PETG material. This material is quite strong and resistant, both physically and up to a temperature of around 90 degrees Celsius without deforming. There is a downside, however. It leaves more strings compared to PLA. I will do a second time lapse with a different orientation of the part, as I'm not very happy with the first result due to some fragile area on the part. Changing the orientation will improve the strength of this fragile feature that I will talk about later in the video. Let me know if you like the time lapse, although the parts have a lot of strings. Do you think I can improve the printing parameters in order to reduce those strings? Let me know in the comments below. Also, some samples of the 3D printing process in real time. And changing the angle. Now let's switch to the boring part. The actual reverse engineering. This is done by measuring the part with a caliper and reproducing it in a 3D CAD software. I will show you both what I measure and also what I design on the computer. Let me know if you like this approach and if you want more videos like this about reverse engineering and CAD design. This 3D modeling took almost 2 hours in real time. Yes, 3D modeling is very time consuming. I have speed things up 5 times in the video, but this will still be really long and boring, so continue watching on your own risk. Are you still watching this? I really appreciate your dedication. Since you have arrived to this point, please subscribe and give a like. It really helps. Thank you.
satisfied. My weakness comes and goes. My weakness comes and goes. I'm reaching out for the easy high. Please fortify this strength of mine. My weakness comes and goes. My weakness comes and goes.
Go home.
So I was talking about a fragile area of the part. This clipping element, or hook, if you like, this is the fragile area. It is quite thin, difficult to 3D print, and depending on the alignment during the 3D printing, will have high risk of breaking during usage. Okay, so the 3D modeling and reverse engineering is done. I can't believe you made it this far into the video. Thanks for watching and let me know in the comments below what do you think about the format of this video. I want to improve the channel and your feedback is the most important for this.